Ouch. Well, I have a lot of fingers, so... And, you know, they regrow. What happens if I grab one? That is a hard hand. Yep. You have to catch it in something that will keep it cold. Oh yeah, okay. I get it. You need the mug from the curio shop. This seems familiar. He has a force field, okay.
Alright.
We'll check all the paintings before we leave. Far away... The Folio Fudo. Oh, it's the hug. It's a hug. Grey hug of Oinos. Might be Utravel. Yep. My poor dear, lovely Manthing. Why, that was your first wish. She points a single bony clawed finger at your forehead. Your temples begin to throb painfully, and you can remember nothing more. The hell? We might have wished to forget then. The final fate of the Thessarian sorcerer Gangroihoidon, Jesus. Oh, I can do that. Yeah, let's save first. ...4,000 experience.
New taunts, alright!
Whoop. Okay. So we died.
Another trip to the mortuary.
Are you alright?
I'm fine. He got a new Kerso. Or an upgraded version. How do I see his ability? Abilities. Is there an abilities button? Can I nod? Read it somehow. It's annoying me. It must be able to do it. What is this? I'm pretty sure there was somewhere to read it, but I don't know where it is now. Welp. Fine. Where are random items down? What? That's weird. That is really weird. These are items I had before, right? Oh, it's Mortis items. Fucking hell, that's the tooth.
Hey!
Why were they here? Ah, okay. Kinda weird. But at least now we know where his items went. I was wondering, what the hell? I don't think I need that anymore, but just keep it, just in case. Now, curious shop. What? Am I in the lower world? I am. Huh. Well, since I'm here, I might as well go help. What's her name? Tris something. Get some money. Ooh, 1,000, that's not bad at all. And 8k of experience.
I'm gone.
So now we can buy more things at the Curio shop. But first I think it's time to speak to Ignis.
I'm gone.
This area is bugging the game out. As far as scrolling goes.
I'm gone.
Well, fine. All right. I'm not sure why it's this specific area. Alright, he goes somewhere in the hive. My god, really? Don't care. Oh, this is the right area. I'm impressed.
Gone.
Yes, I can't actually scroll anymore. Alright. End game.
I'm gone.
I'm gonna start the game, but meh. I probably stop soon, so I'll deal with it. Your time has come. I know you. The creature face splits. Yes. Ignis.
Till death comes for us both.
Alrighty. New companion. Which is kinda evil, but whatever. That's a complicated story, which we will learn. Things burn inside. Only need to be kindled with flames to become Ignus. Or might you have been Ignus? Oh, he might teach you fire spells, I don't remember actually. But I wish to speak of flames Ignus and of burning. Ignus once knew nothing of flames. He set small fires, tiny flames. Okay. They sought to punish Ignus, the small flies from the hive. They wished to see Ignus burn. Tiny magelings, yep, okay. The plains burn and all life is torchless, then Ignus will at last be at peace. There we go. Spoke with someone and he mentioned that someone taught you these things. Who? You have always taught Ignus. Ignus master you were.
Updated my journal.
It is the only reason Ignus obeys you, till death comes for us both. Your words to me, to your student Ignus. Ignus has not forgotten master. Aha, okay. A frail youth steps into the edges of the firelight. Master, you have already intruded, supplicant. You did so with intention. I will hear it now. Master, I dreamed of flames again. They felt real. You said that they were to come to you if... I woke and my hands were as us. He's still trembling, but there is an eagerness in his voice which angers you. I do not lie, it was the dream that burned me. They were your words and I came to repeat them to you and tell you they were true. Jesus Christ, we're an asshole. Know that flames can burn, and if you would learn their power, you must suffer their touch. He seems mesmerized, staring into the flames. His tears have dried in the heat, and the second is gone. The flames are his focus. He's not listening to you, and you feel fury washing over you. If that is what consumes you, enough for you to intrude upon my meditation, then I shall teach you the shaping of the flames. Jesus Christ. And we burned his hands. Awesome. To learn, you must suffer. You must allow yourself to be burned by the power of that which you wield. Know its torment, and you shall know how to use it against your enemies.
Updated my journal.
Master, Ignus has not forgotten your teachings. Jesus, nice. As you're about to speak the words, you feel a crawling sensation in the back of your skull, and you are suddenly struck with a certainty that the knowledge Ignus has to teach may permanently scar you. Let's not do that yet. I'm not sure. About your teachings, about the torments I subjected you, I'm sorry, he won't like that. You don't know if the words meant anything to you. Are you sure, supplicant? Stops and he whirls on you. Supplicant no more. Ignus will burn you. This is awesome, by the way, I won't do that. Okay. This is a great character for an evil playthrough, but I'm not sure how it will work with me being kinda leaning towards good. Let's see what happens to Drusilla. Yep. And Drusilla's gone. That's what you get for loving the fire.
If you keep bobbing about, Skull, I'm gonna mount you in the end of a pike.
Alright. Tongues of flame, searing flames, infernal orb, ignus terror, infernal shield, fiery rain, elemental strike. This guy is fire everywhere. Well, he's basically fire, so it makes sense. All right. All right. I think I will end the stream here since my neighbor decided to play the piano, and that may be heard through the microphone. I'll be back with more Planescape Torment, but for now, thank you for watching. Those of you on YouTube, as usually, subscribe, like, leave a comment if you want to, and I will see you next time with more Planescape Torment.